So what brings you down here today? What's your main concern?
Main concern is the city. Everybody I see when I'm driving home from work, I'm still working, I'm a construction worker, so it's not like I'm in this for myself, it's not like I'm out of business or whatever, but when I'm driving to and from work and I see lineups of people all wearing masks, I see businesses going out of business, I see the hospitals empty when I've been going to hospitals, people getting denied surgery and operations. Because of something that is so less severe than what it's being made out to seem. So I feel like I have to, me as a man, as a person that's living, I have to stick up for everybody and be vocal and speak with everybody to try to get everybody on the same page. Because I feel like there's a lot of people that are just getting manipulated through media, mainstream media that you see on TV and everything, and they twist words, they will take a fact and stretch it, and if you just see a headline, it's easy to just see a headline and say, oh no, and be scared. But there's so many ways to do your own investigation right now, through social media, through the internet. Just start researching everything you see. Don't believe everything. Don't trust anything. Do your own research. Go with your own instinct. And then arrive at a conclusion. Don't be afraid to talk to other people. That's why something like this is perfect. Like, I encourage everybody to come out. Even if you want to wear a mask and stay at a distance or whatever, at least come out and talk to people who are actually speaking from the other side. And that's how you become educated. You don't have to agree with everything, but at least be open and receptive to different ways of looking at things.
And how do you feel about that before?
You know what? I've always liked Doug Ford as a down-to-earth person, and I think he's the way he's handled. He's taken a lot of good leadership qualities in terms of standing up and like walking the walk, like you know, picking up the mask and everything. But at the same time, when it comes to sticking up for business owners, all that kind of stuff, everything that he has built the whole Ford nation on, he's going against all that right now because he's leaving those people hung out to dry. It's all the big corporations that are still going. And I don't think he's doing a good job. Sorry, that's my opinion. I hope he starts to kind of wake up because I feel like the data is here. The data is here to indicate that it's not the best solution to keep everything locked down. So I'm really hoping that Doug Ford will kind of come around.
And how do you feel about what he's doing so far?
I think it's way too slow. I think phase one, phase two, phase three, the goalposts are getting pushed way farther back. It's like another 2 weeks. And it's almost like it's making us feel like we should be grateful that we're allowed to go to a beach or to a park. How can you deny people the right to go to a beach or a park and have the right to do other things, whether it's a liquor store, whether it's a Walmart, whether it's buying cigarettes? It makes no sense at all. It's like, come on, like let's just use our common sense here.
And how do you feel about the gun ban?
I am not a personal gun owner. I've never had an interest in this. But the way that it was gone about, there was no democratic process. It was just kind of thrown in there on the people from Trudeau. So I do not support that whatsoever. And it also, to me, it symbolizes a loss of rights. Taking away people's rights to bear arms, and that's less power for the people, more power for the government.
Do you think the mainstream media promotes fear, and how do you feel about that?
Absolutely, I feel that is the biggest problem there is. They promote fear. But I have people like my sister, okay, and she's a social worker, and she when she comes over to our house to see my mom and myself, she comes over with Lysol wipes and hand sanitizer. She wipes down toilet seats and door handles. That's how much fear is being instilled in people. That is not healthy for anybody. Like that's like OCD. That's like it's crazy. And so the media is the biggest problem there is in my opinion. Do your own research, all right? Don't just turn on the TV here and grab the headlines and say that's the way it is. Do your own research.
Do you think the media is biased to one side?
Yes, generally speaking, the media is so far left on the left side of things, like on the liberal side, and I don't want to play politics here, because this shouldn't be a vote which side you identify to. This is about all of us coming together. We should all be able to come to the agreement that this is not good for anybody, losing our rights and freedoms like this. This is good for nobody.
Have you heard anything about what's going on in the U.S. with the protests down there and some of the laws that the government's...
I'm not too much about the protests, but in terms of Wisconsin had their lockdown restricted, or everything reopened apparently. And the bars were filling up and everything, and I haven't heard of any problems since. And just like here, I mean, look at everybody else, and everybody else, sorry, kind of going off topic, but like everybody's fine. So I think if state by state, province by province, country by country start to reopen, we'll see that really these measures aren't needed.
And you think the political leaders have been critical in, going to their cottages and doing all that stuff?
It's like say as we say, or do as we say, but not as we do. You know, they tell everybody else to stay inside, this and that, and then you have Doug Ford. It came out that he went to his cottage. He had visitors. So, come on, it's everybody's on the same side of the playing field here. We're all together. You got it. Like, you're saying you're leading by example, Doug Ford. But like, how is that leading by example? That's not a leader.
And is there anything that you'd say to any the average person out there?
Yeah, I had a video that I put up.
The average person?
Yeah, the average person. And anyone that wouldn't come out. Anything you'd say to them?
I'd say feel comfortable. Feel comfortable. It's not like we're hooligans or yahoos like Doug Ford called us. Every time I speak about Ford, I think like I might have taken it too easy on him, because there's a lot of things that Doug Ford, it's like, come on, you're calling us yahoos. Just why don't you talk to some of these people? Everybody, there's so many educated, healthy people here. These are the people you want to listen to. So don't feel shy, even if you disagree initially. Talk to some of us. You know, whether or not you come here, talk to us on the internet, this and that. I'm not out to bury somebody and put you down and say, I'm right, you're wrong. It's not about that. It's about having an engageful conversation. Like, I'll listen to your side, you listen to our side, right?
Are you a supporter of independent media?
Yes, 100%. Rebel News does a great job. I just found out like a couple weeks ago at the protest, so I guess you're doing your own thing too. So yeah, I do support independent. That's actually a really good thing, because we gotta eliminate some of this fear and have people open to seeing a wide variety of sources, aside from your typical CBC, CP24, CNN, that are creating all the problems.
Thanks a lot, brother.
Thank you.